I've been walking with my face turned to the sun. I walked into this store and I got all the crystals. I put my tarot card, like I did a reading on myself. Like, I'm so excited. I'm ready to dig into this. This is so exciting.
Did you even protect yourself first? Did you cleanse the crystals? Do you even know which crystals mean what? Did you spend any time with the tarot cards to connect with them? Did you? Nothing?
You know, why do I have to like meditate all the time? Like when I be meditating, I just be falling asleep. I don't get it.
Keep doing it. With much practice, young one, you will see the importance of hearing from your spirit guides. You got to get them downloads. Keep it up.
I also did this ritual the other day and I was specific. It did not come true. Ain't shit happened. This shit does not work.
The damn sure ain't gonna work now. You just proclaimed it so. Watch your words, young one. Never ever say the ritual didn't work. You got to give it time.
It's also this other spell that I want to do, but I gotta wait for my supplies to get here because I don't have no green candle, I don't have no flower lilies, I don't have frankincense oil, I don't have nothing.
Rookie mistake number one. Roses substitute every flower, olive oil can substitute any oil, and a white candle substitute every candle in the store. Don't ever hold off on your spell work or your ritual just because you feel like you don't have all the ingredients or supplies. Block your blessings like that.
Five statements that'll make you a better witch. You don't have to meditate every day. Not everyone feels like they can meditate every day or have the time. Do it when you need to or have rituals such as before doing spell work. It's okay for things not to resonate with you. For example, if you don't like crystals, you don't have to use crystals. Period. Not all deities are gonna like you. Get over it. You don't have to work with your ancestors. Being spiritual and reaching your higher self does not mean that you have to practice live, laugh, love, and it does not mean you have to forgive everyone, and it does not mean that you cannot stick up for yourself.
Spiritual TikTok, witch talk, I'm not trying to offend anybody and I'm not trying to offend my mutual in which I was having this conversation with, but we have to talk about something. I was watching this video from a dream psychic talking about their precognitive dreams. I too have the gift of prophecy, foretelling, whatever the fuck you want to call it. I believe I've inherited my gift from my father. So Al, the dream psychic, I believe that's his name, was talking about how he's been dreaming of muddy water. I told y'all, those of y'all that are in my private group, I've been dreaming of tsunamis. I've been dreaming of massive fucking floods. Mutual was saying, this is just scaring people. Maybe we should just encourage them to wake up. But y'all have this ass backwards ideology as to what spirituality is. It's not all love and light. It's not if you are spiritual, you are immediately protected from all things that are bad, especially those of y'all that subscribe to this new earth theory where you think there's going to be this high vibrational split and you will be unscathed, untouched, unbothered by the things still happening on this fucking planet. That is so fucking dense. That is so fucking toxic. That is so fucking elitist. In fact, that y'all are saying that tells me you haven't done any shadow work. Y'all are thriving in your ego and teaching people out of your fucking ego, mainly because y'all are scared and don't want to address your own fucking fears. There are going to be bad things that happen, whether you are spiritual or not. Some of us will feel those effects, even if your vibration is the highest of the high. Why? Because your ass is not untouchable. I love learning from these self-proclaimed shamans named Sarah that did shrooms once in the fucking woods, and now they think because they had some enlightening moments, they're the chosen one. This is the problem with learning from people that only want to teach, but also don't want to be a student themselves. Y'all have to be forever students when you are a spiritualist. Sometimes, no, forever student, often a teacher, sometimes the fucking expert, but rarely. And being a forever student is not researching every conspiracy theory you can find and trying to figure out where in the puzzle it fits. That's not what spirituality is. And a lot of y'all have been taken down that road and just led into a rabbit hole with no real substance. What the fuck are y'all doing?
All right, if you are somebody just starting your spiritual journey or you feel stuck on your spiritual journey, then this video is for you. I'm going to go through three different things that you can do to help you successfully start or continue your journey. Number one, shadow work. Now, a lot of people get shadow work a little misconstrued, right? When you come into spirituality, you start hearing about this word shadow work, and it's like, well, what the hell is it, right? Shadow work is nothing more than self-development. Figuring out those parts of yourself that lie in the shadows, those things that are subconscious that you need to work on. This usually involves trauma healing, childhood healing, and things along that line. An easy way to start tapping into shadow work is to start journaling. Writing down things that you want to release, write down things that no longer serve you, write down old memories or old events that may have happened that still are kind of fresh in your brain or things that taunt you over and over, and start to release and get that shit up out of your energy. Number two, meditation. Now, a lot of people get meditation a little fucked up too, okay? A lot of people get frustrated because, number one, you start off trying to meditate for like 30 minutes and it's your first time. And then number two, you get irritated because you're trying to clear your mind the whole time and you realize that doesn't really work. The key to meditation is, number one, start with smaller time frames. So see if you can go for a minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, and then up your time every couple of weeks. Number two, the goal is not to get your mind to be completely blank, but to get your mind to learn to focus. So try a mantra, repeating that over and over in your head, or try to focus on one thing at a time. And number three, last but not least, is your ancestors or your spirit team. Now, I get asked a lot of questions about how do we connect with our ancestors? How do we connect with our spirit team? Basic conversation. Start with basic conversation. When you wake up in a rising, say hello, thank you for this day, thank you for helping me, assisting me in advance, or whatever the case is, thank you for watching over my family as they slept, blah 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 blah, so on and so forth. The same way that you would talk to grandma if she was here, or grandpa if he was here, is the same way that you communicate with your ancestors. It's literally that simple. If you can start with these three things and start to master these three things, then I promise you that your journey will start on the right foot.
What inspired you to become a Black witch? So my parents, they never forced me to believe in any religion. I wasn't forced to go to church. I was able to take my own path, use my own mind, and go with that. So I always was into like paranormal activity. I used to try to call in spirits when I was younger. Like, I was just into all the crazy stuff. And after plenty of research, I found that witchcraft is my path. Like, it's just so natural. It helps with my healing process. It keeps me at peace, keeps me happy. Nothing else makes me happy like witchcraft does. So nobody could tell me anything. That's why I never care about what people say. I live freely. I'm a free spirit. I do what I want when I want to do it. And nobody can tell me my path isn't the right path. And that's on period.
Baby, just off the fact that you're aware that you want to start your spiritual journey is you starting your spiritual journey. Everyone's spiritual journey starts off differently. Everybody's spiritual journey is different. So it's really up to you and what you feel called to do. But I'll give you some tips and recommendations, and you can do whatever you want with this information. First, starting off, you have to realize that you are a divine being having a human experience, and life is literally an illusion. And the purpose of life is literally just to help your soul grow and learn. The number one priority of your spiritual journey is to get to know yourself and get to know your life's purpose, get to know why you're here, get to connect with yourself. That being said, I'll recommend that you do some practices that help you become more self-aware, like meditating. The act of meditating is so simple, but yet it is so powerful. For me personally, meditating has helped me so much. It has helped me literally feel my own energy. It has helped me grow my own personal gifts. It has helped me become more in tune with myself. It has helped me to recognize and separate my mind, body, and spirit. It also has helped me to connect with my higher self, connect with literally like anyone who I want to talk to. Now, I'm not gonna lie, when you first start out, meditating is very hard. It is literally a practice. Just like everything else in spirituality, you have to keep practicing and practicing and practicing until you get better at it. Meditating too also helps you become more self-aware and live in the present moment. That way you're not distracted from outside things. Also, to pray for guidance. You know, you have a spiritual team, you have a higher self. God, the divine, can help you on your journey. Just pray about it. Ask them to show you your next steps. And trust me, you will see it. They will show it to you. You can ask to be shown specific signs and different things like that. Everyone's spirit guides and everyone's people communicates with them differently. And just like any other relationship, the connection between you and your spirit guides, you and your spiritual team, gets stronger over time, the more that you talk to them. Also, too, astrology will help you so much. That is actually the first thing I learned on my spiritual journey, and it has helped me basically know my life's purpose. Another thing as well, connect with nature. Ground yourself in nature. Get some plants. Get some rocks. It's going to definitely help you feel grounded throughout this whole process. Also, too, knowledge is power, so I would definitely recommend that you read some books. Some books that I've personally read and some books that a lot of spiritualists recommend are The Four Agreements, The Sacred Woman, The Alchemist, Outwitting the Devil, The Game of Life and How to Play It, just to name a few. Also, too, do not fall in the rabbit hole. Learn to listen to your intuition and learn how to protect your energy.
TV shows, these niggas wouldn't know how to be gangster. Free all of my niggas who locked in them chains, and free all of my niggas with blocks on their ankles. The only reason that bitch ain't get hit up, cause she was with her son, so that bitch better thank him. But if we catch that bitch out with her mama, they both get in touch. What the fuck was you thinking? I'm in the club, niggas can't get behind us. They call it drip, but I call it designer. I'm on these fuck niggas head like a lineup. Said I'm hard to touch, but it's not hard to find us.